Hey guys, for those of you who don't know, I'm a huge fan of professional wrestling. Whether it be the old territory days, the Hulk Hogan era of the 80s, the Attitude era, and the new era with all the crazy independent shows that are pretty much everything that's not WWE is fucking awesome, and everything that is WWE fucking sucks. But I want to look back on something that happened right after the death of WCW and ECW from 2002. Because so many people were still looking to try to get an alternative to WWE that they were so desperate that some people actually looked at the garbage pile that is XPW. And today, we're looking at one of their shows called Liberty or Death. How bad is it? Well, let's find out, mother muchachos. Let's begin. Alright, match one is Steve Rosano versus Scott Snot. Okay, why the fuck would you name yourself that? Was because Bastard Booger was taken? What the fuck is that on his head? He's got a hat attached to a wig? This guy's got, what, a computer nerd gimmick? Honestly, you really think that's gonna get you over? This guy better be good in the ring. And look at Steve Rosano over here. He looks like a Wish version of Steve Corino. He's holding up a fan sign in an attempt to mock him, I guess? I have no idea what the sign even says. The video quality is so poor. Snot actually seems to be kind of over with the crowd, which is surprising. And I just realized how flat Rosano's butt is. And what's with the ring announcer? He looks like a guy who'd be smoking weed on your couch all day. Both guys lock up and it looks kind of shitty. As Rosano gets a couple arm drags in. Rosano hits a hip toss, and then he plays to the crowd some more and starts... I don't know what this is. Did he think he was an ostrich for a quick second? Guys are just standing around in their corners not doing nothing. Both guys lock up again after a minute, and Snot hits a decent-looking hip toss. It's a leg takedown. And we get a little bit of chain wrestling here. Snot attempts a couple of roll-ups, but both of them end in a two count. Rosano with a boot to the midsection, as both guys just kind of trade blows for a bit. Forearms, chops, all that shit. Rosano hits a pretty good back suplex, surprisingly, but Snot doesn't look like he took it too well. Looks like he landed right on his fucking head. Rosano gets Snot in a terrible-looking camel clutch. If it even is a camel clutch, I have no idea what he's trying to do here. It just looks bad. Then Vic Grimes shows up. Yeah, remember him? He's the guy who nearly killed New Jack, and then New Jack nearly killed him. Grimes cuts a promo asking the fans whether or not he wants to see these two guys wrestle, or if they want to see him kick these two guys' asses, and they vote for the latter. Not really much to say about this match. I'm gonna give it an F because, frankly, it just gets thrown out when Vic Grimes shows up and beats their asses. But then, what the hell? Okay, apparently this guy's name is Tool, but what is he? He's a wrestling gimp? That's so fucked up. It's a pretty good power slam on Tool, as I guess we have a match now. Then he gets a spinning leg drop. Grimes is battering on Tool, but Tool fights back and hits a spine buster. Just kind of stomps on him for a bit. This guy just looks so weird. I mean, why would you have a wrestling gimp? And was that this one guy who I have no idea who he is? Is that supposed to be, like, his slave master? Is this the guy from the basement in Pulp Fiction got all jacked and decided to become a wrestler? He stomps on him some more. He's not too bad in the ring. It's just his gimmick is just so fucking disturbing. Tool goes up to the top and hits a guillotine leg drop. God damn, I'm a huge mark for big men that can do stuff like that. Tool is just left wide open with his crotch like that, which makes his gimmick a lot more awkward, especially because Grimes just slammed his ass into his face. Oh, come on, Grimes, now you're choking him? Jeez, we know he's a gimp. He's getting tortured. Grimes slams his ass into his face again, then he just starts screaming at the crowd. And then gets him in a... He's walking on the damn top rope, and it's a flying kick. Hot damn. Both of these guys can do high-flying springboard shit. That's awesome. Take the fight outside. As Grimes just kind of looks confused as to where he's at. The Tool hits a pretty shitty hip toss onto I have no idea what because the crowd's fucking heads are blocking it. Okay, it looks like, I guess that was a bench. Back near the ring, Grimes whips Tool into the guardrail. Oh, then dives over the into the crowd, but nearly squishing that kid in the front seat. Who the hell brought their kid to this event? These guys start fighting in the front row.
Grimes picks up I have no idea what that is. And just rams it into Tool's face. Grimes goes to the top, then that weird dude shoves him off and then flops onto the thing. Then the referee hits that guy in the back of the head. Grimes hits a pretty iffy looking Samoan drop. It's okay though, because he's a fat guy. Grimes then tries to go up top again, but then the dude in zebra pants shows up. He grabs him, looks like he's trying to grab him by the dick, but he just can't reach it. Then Tool goes up after him. Tool hits a choke slam from the top rope, which on it looked pretty cool. It's over. Tool wins. This match wasn't that bad. I'll give it a C+.
After that match, R-Truth shows up. Yeah, surprised to see him here. He's with two other dudes, and apparently he's making his debut at this show, and he's cutting a promo, basically saying, white man bad, black man good, white man ain't nothing but a... After that promo goes on for like 6 minutes, our next match is we get a Lucha Libre tag team match between Mexico's Most Wanted, Damian and Halloween, probably best known for their work in WCW and, well, in Mexico, against two indie luchadors known as Venom Black and Ecstasis. Halloween kind of does some typical heel shit by hitting a shoulder block, taunting to the crowd, and slapping Venom Black around a bit. But I just gotta bring up, I've never really heard about Venom Black or Ecstasis before this match, and I haven't really heard anything from after this match. And these guys are just, they're skinnier than Spike Dudley, like holy shit. Like, Zach Gowen and Spike Dudley both are probably telling him to put on some meat. Venom Black gets a pretty good pop-up spine buster. Then we get a kind of sloppy drop-down thing into an arm drag. We get some chops and some chain wrestling. Venom Black gets a pretty nice drop kick to the leg, but I think it's because Halloween sold that really well. Get an exchange of arm drags and a drop kick that misses. Venom Black kips up, which gets the crowd going. Halloween and Damian, they try to walk away from the match because they're heels and they're cowards. But Venom Black and Ecstasis get the crowd going and try to get them to run back into the ring. Mexico's Most Wanted come back in as Ecstasis moonsaults and fall onto his feet off the top rope. Pretty impressive. Damian hits a flapjack on Ecstasis. Then Ecstasis demonstrates some pretty cool moves. Halloween hits a gorilla press slam on Venom Black. Honestly, can't be that hard. The guy looks like he weighs lighter than air.
And we then see a move that I've never honestly seen before, where Venom Black heck springs off of Halloween's feet and then lands on his feet, then gets hit by a super kick. Honestly, that is some pretty cool shit. In early 2000s indie wrestling was crazy. Venom Black and Halloween are on the top rope as Halloween goes for Hurricane Rana, but Venom Black very badly tries to crotch Halloween on the rope, but honestly, it looks pretty bad. But then he hits a decent-looking Hurricane Rana. But Venom reverses into a kind of shitty-looking Hurricane Rana. But then Ecstasis hits a better-looking one on Damian. Then I have no idea what the hell just happened, but it sends Mexico's Most Wanted flopping out. Then they go for a double suicide dive, but then they stop it and roll back in. But say, these guys are super skinny, but they're pretty damn athletic. Damian hits a chop on Ecstasis and Venom Black is still in the ring, does nothing about it, then does the giant swing. Looks like Cesaro owes this guy a few new royalties. Damian then looks like he goes for a muscle buster. Damn, now Samoa Joe owes this guy some royalties? Venom Black breaks up the pin as Damian then goes after him. Mexico's Most Wanted then hit the poetry in motion. Okay, now these guys, now they owe royalties to the Hardy Boys. But then they slam Black's crotch into the ring post. Halloween does some more heel shtick on Ecstasis in the ring. And Ecstasis fights back with really weak-looking chops. And Halloween just beats the ever-loving fuck out of him in the corner. You get a double gorilla press slam as Ecstasis falls hard to the mat. And then they hit, I don't even know what this move is, but it's pretty damn cool. Followed by an elbow drop and a drop kick to the face. hitting double corner splashes on Damien. Then ducking a clothesline and slamming Halloween headfirst into his crotch.
That looks kind of dirty.
Again, then get a double Hurricane Rana into a victory roll pin. 2 count. So far this match has had some pretty good luchador action. Although some of, and particularly Venom Black's moves have looked kind of sloppy. And Venom Black hits a springboard swanton onto Damien outside. Then in the ring, Ecstasis hits another flying Hurricane Rana. Then Halloween hits an F5 on Ecstasis? 1, 2, and 0. Even the referee pinning looked kind of sloppy. Then Damien does a Val Venus dance in the middle of the ring. But yeah, this match, I'm gonna give it a B+. A pretty good way to get the crowd going and actually showed some entertaining moves. I have never heard of Venom Black or Ecstasis outside of this match, and from what I've researched, there doesn't seem to be very much about them at all. But regardless, this wasn't bad. After Supreme cuts a promo, we then get a match between him and Crimson, and honestly, he has got to be the absolute worst fucking wrestler I've ever seen. Yeah, him and the trash bag man do some shitty moves, they brawl for a little bit, Crimson gets him with a fucking box cutter and makes him bleed all over the place. Supreme hits possibly the shittiest fucking suicide dive I'd ever seen. Like, it even looks like Crimson tries to catch him. And then they start brawling in the crowd, and yeah, for like a solid 6 minutes, I can't fucking see anything. Like, the fans are just covering up the entire damn thing. It's ridiculous. And then it just cuts to the next match. We never see what exactly happens for the end of this match. Fuck it. This match gets a big old F. R-Truth shows up again, this time wrestling in a match, tag teaming with one of those two other dudes. Apparently his name is Rafael Muhammad, and the only data I could find on him was his matches here in XPW. And they're taking on these two other guys who I also could only find their work in XPW, who named the Tex-Mex Express. Just a fat white dude in overalls and a fat Mexican dude in his street clothes. Anyway, chubby black dude and fat Mexican dude start things off with some pretty sloppy chain wrestling. Yeah, these guys kind of go back and forth for a bit. As Muhammad hits a really weird looking front drop kick, and for some reason the fat Mexican dude sells it like it kicked him in the junk. Then tags in the fat white dude. But then, luckily, hopefully this match will be saved as Truth gets tagged in. And apparently here he's named K. Malik Shabazz, so I guess that's what I'm going to call him for the rest of this event. Get a surprisingly good drop toe hold from the white guy, and then he gets some pretty good punches in the corner on the Truth. Truth crouches himself on the middle turnbuckle and then sells it like a fucking cartoon character. Truth hits a nice looking STO on the fat white dude, but then it starts to kind of go to shit as the fat Mexican is tagged back in. And the chubby black dude shows up and they just start ganging up on the fat Mexican dude, and the referee really does nothing about it. K. Malik and Muhammad hit a double back body drop on the fat Mexican, and honestly, I can't stand the trope where the referee is too busy just yelling at the tag team partner for nothing while the other team just goes to town on his partner, like there with the double hip toss. They go for a double clothesline, but fat white guy just kind of forgets to take the bump. Fat Mexican is beating up K. Malik Shabazz on outside while the other two guys are still going at it in the ring. Then the fat white guy, I think he's having a heart attack because he's so fat, and then the black guy hits the shittiest bulldog ever. Seriously, he's like K. Malik Shabazz, like, or R-Truth, or K. Quick, Run the Truth Killings, whatever the hell his name is this week. Like, yeah, like, honestly, is he the only talented guy in this match? Overalls man goes up top, but then he gets quickly knocked off the ring apron by one of the other two dudes. Black dude gets him in, I think it was for a torture rack, and he hits a that. Then the referee fucks up counting the pin, and just like, he does like a slow count, hesitant count, I don't know what the hell that was. Either way, like, fat white guy kicks out. Hey, Malik Shabazz tags back in and hits a front suplex. I think the ref is trying to throw the match out? I don't know. Then the bell rings. Chubby black guy then clotheslines fat white dude out of the ring, and then I guess the match just kind of stops. That's honestly really stupid. I mean, R-Truth is a great wrestler. And yeah, I never heard of these other three dudes, like these other three clowns, but you know, like, the fat white dude at least hits some decent moves. And you know, the fat black dude at least did some okay moves when he was double teaming with Truth. But yeah, no, this match sucks. I'm gonna give it a D. Right before the next match, where some Guy Fieri looking motherfucker and his tag team partner, who's an Eminem wannabe, take on these guys called the Altar Boys, who look exactly the same. And they introduce their new manager, Major Guns. And now there's two reasons why I'm interested in this match. And she almost trips on while making her entrance. Guy Fieri and one of the Bald Brothers locks up, and we get a little bit of chain wrestling. Surprisingly, the Guy Fieri looking motherfucker, he's surprisingly not too bad in the ring. One of the bald dudes hits a hip toss. Then a Japanese arm drag. Yeah, we actually get a pretty decent back and forth as Guy Fieri hits a clothesline. Some random ass dude who hits a really shitty drop kick while the other two guys had better drop kicks on him. Then the other guy walks in and, you know, doesn't really tag into the match here. Like, these guys are wearing the same clothes and they both have shaved heads. I have no idea which one is which. And wannabe shoves one of them to the ground, then tags Fieri right back in. Or I guess not. Altar Boy fights back as we, again, get some pretty decent back and forth. We get a nice exchange of arm drags, and yeah, then one of the bald dudes starts beating on Eminem wannabe. I'm actually quite impressed with some of the in-ring work in this match. It's not bad. Which is kind of surprising, because like, the only one of these guys I know is that one of these Altar Boys would go on to become Luke Hawks, while these other guys are fading to obscurity. One of them hits a nice karate kick, to roundhouse kick to the head. And while the Guy Fieri dude, like, despite being all chubby, is surprisingly agile. I really don't have much to say about this match other than, you know, the ring work is really good. I was going into this match thinking it's gonna be like some stupid gimmicks or something. And there surprisingly haven't been that many cuts to Major Guns at ringside. Wannabes miss a double clothesline as one of the Altar Boys hits a DDT on Eminem. They both miss roundhouse kicks and they get a double drop kick, which is really damn good. Eminem gets one of the Altar Boys on a Cobra Clutch, and then it just kind of flops out of it. Okay, so there's a bit of sloppy stuff in here. But then we get a nice Russian leg sweep by one of the Altar Boys. Altar Boy then goes up top and goes for a, whoa, the corkscrew splash but misses. And then Eminem kind of dances around like a goof before hitting an elbow drop. Damn, nice Michinoku driver from Shady. Yeah, I am impressed, because like, I know apparently these guys were like backyard wrestlers, but yeah, they actually have some talent. Hey, Fury tags back in, hits a nice heel kick, but only gets a two count. Man, Altar Boy takes Fury out with a nice drop kick, but then Daniel-san looking dude gets on the ring apron but gets kicked off. And it's a springboard moonsault that looks a little sloppy, but still not bad. Slim Shady then runs the ropes and hits a much better suicide dive than fucking Supreme earlier. And one of the Altar Boys does that crazy looking move and lands on his feet? Haha, damn! Back in the ring, Guy Fieri and one of the Altar Boys once again do some pretty good moves as the Altar Boy gets a springboard sunset flip. Eminem gets back in the ring as we pretty much abandon the tag team rules by now. And shows off his dance moves for hitting a leg drop. But the other Altar Boy breaks it up with a karate kick. A lot of karate moves in this match. Man, T-Bone suplex onto Eminem. But only for a two count as Fieri breaks that up. Nice powerbomb by Guy Fieri. Seriously, I was not expecting, like, anything out of this match, but holy shit, this is good. Eminem goes up top and hits a nice swanton bomb, and it's over. Yeah, this match was actually pretty damn good, despite the fact that, you know, I couldn't tell the Altar Boys apart, and yeah, these guys are complete ripoffs of other celebrities. Well, I mean, at least the Eminem-looking guy is. I don't know if Guy Fieri was really a thing back in 2002. But yeah, still. And it's also kind of, it's not really believable that a chick as smoking as Major Guns would be with these two dudes. And I have no idea who that Daniel-san-looking dude who over there is. Wait, and what the hell? Then the altar boys start making out? What the hell? I never thought I'd say this, but I might. I'm actually going to give this match an A. So far, best match of the night. Well done. Well, folks, hope you enjoyed that match, because this very next match is the first and only Raw Sewage match, or at least I hope it is, in the history of professional wrestling, between GQ Money and Veronica Kane versus Lizzie Borden and Hardcore Homo Angel. That's just such an idiotic and disgusting premise for a match. Why would you have that? And plus, GQ Money and Hardcore Homo Angel are actually two pretty good wrestlers, but they had to tag team with these untrained porn stars. Just fucking why? And they gotta dunk them in the kiddie pools full of crap? Like, I seriously hope it's not real poop in there and it's just like mud or something. Ugh. And it certainly doesn't help that the majority of this match, the announcers are calling it the poo-poo. Anyway, Angel gets into the ring with a chair, but GQ Money attacks him, and they brawl for a bit, where Angel hits him in the face with the chair, and GQ Money sells it kind of weird, then he dropkicks the chair into Angel's face. GQ Money has a pipe, and he slams the chair into Angel's face, and Veronica Kane just looks absolutely clueless as to what she's actually supposed to be doing. Then Veronica Kane goes for a people's elbow? What? But no, then she actually drops her pussy on Angel's face. Which, you know, Angel's disgusted by because...
Get it? He's gay! Gay!
Then This Love by Pantera starts playing. Okay, I'll admit Lizzie Borden does have good taste in music. And she's another big boob blonde wearing a white shirt and black sweatpants. So these two chicks look exactly the fucking same. How the hell am I supposed to tell them apart? Okay, I guess we can tell them apart because Veronica Kane's got her hair in a hair done a different way from Lizzie Borden. But yeah, when that gets messed up, it'll be like that Britney Spears versus Christina Aguilera episode of Celebrity Deathmatch. Anyway, yeah, we get some shitty brawling when the two porn stars start going at it, and GQ hits a spear on Lizzie. GQ hits a dropkick on Angel, then he grabs Lizzie and then Veronica Kane. What the? What are they doing? What the fuck? Oh, no. What the? No. What? Why is that? He's going to rape her? That's what a GQ Money signature moves? He's a fucking rapist? What? Ew, what the fuck? Oh, thank God, Angel saves her. Oh my God, that's what? Why would you have that as your gimmick? That's fucking awful. Anyway, we get more shitty cat fight. Do I even care at this point? I mean, you literally just had a spot where you're about to rape a chick. You know what? I'm not even giving this match the rest of the satisfaction after that. Yeah, there's a bunch more shitty brawling. There's a bunch more, like, crazy spots and some shit where, like, they're about to, like, dunk each other in the fucking poo-poo, as the announcers call it. Yeah, a bunch of five-year-olds over there. Yeah, there's a couple run-ins where, like, Chaos and Steve Rosano and, like, a bunch of other dudes run in and, like, they're helping out in the fight and shit. But I do not give one solitary crap, no pun intended, but that rape spot just disgusted me. This whole thing is absolute shit, and then it ends with this spot where fucking GQ Money and Angel are up on this high scaffold and they crash into what, a kiddie pool full of crap that was also covered by like barbed wire tables. Like, oh my God, what kind of wrestling match is this? This is not wrestling. This is pure shit. That time pun was intended. This match can take two middle fingers and shove it up the fucking Rob Black's stupid fucking ass. Fuck this match. So after that piece of shit match, no kidding, we get La Parca versus Psychosis. And yeah, it's a really damn good match. It doesn't even belong on this show, to be honest. I mean, LaParca and Psychosis, I mean, there's really not much to talk about. I mean, it's just a really damn good match between Lucha Libre legends. Yeah, definitely give this match a watch. Just skip over, like, pretty much everything else. Well, not everything else, but still. But... Rape spot, really? Anyway, yeah, this match gets an A+. Like, no doubt, best match of the night. And, yeah, and LaParca wins by hitting a powerbomb onto some chairs and doing a funny little dance on the chair afterwards. Before the next match, some jerk-off in an ascot, he cuts a promo hyping up Juventud Guerrera and Vinny Massaro. Boy, is that a random team. Before they take on the team of Pogo the Clown, who... Why the fuck would you name yourself after a serial killer? And Juan Tostico, who's one of the guys from the commentary team who looks like Rob Schneider from 51st Dates.
Come on, give her the wiki kiki sneaky between the cheeky.
Oh.
Anyway, for most of this match, Hoovy and Vinny are just beating the shit out of Rob Schneider, as Rob Schneider, I think it's like five moves in this match. Like, six. He gets some kicks in the dick, he dropkicks Vinny Massaro twice, he actually gets the big man up for a snap suplex, which is surprisingly, and that's pretty impressive. And then he hits a moonsault in the end to win the match. Meanwhile, most of the match is just that idiotic trope of wrestling where one of the tag team partners gets the shit kicked out of him, and then he has to tag into his partner, who ends up saving the day in the end, and they win. Like, come on, you guys are a tag team. You both should be pulling your damn weight. This match gets a D. It's not good. Like, in the slightest. I hate to say that, because Hoovy and Vinny are great wrestlers, but... Sorry, just... No, it's not good. It's just not! Okay, the next match kind of pisses me off, because on one end, it's a really friggin' good match between Chris Hamrick and the television champion Chaos. And, yeah, I mean, Chaos actually has kind of a cool gimmick where he's wearing the title belt throughout the majority of the match, and... Yeah, I really like that. I wish more heel champions did that. Like, they flaunt the fact that they're the champion by wearing the belt throughout the match. That's really cool. And, yeah, the match is really friggin' good. Lots of great moves, great athleticism. It's, like, really what's missing from a good chunk of this card. I mean, other than the Psychosis and LaParca match. But then there's a period of time when they go into the crowd, fans keep walking in front of the camera, I can't see shit, and it lasts for a bit too damn long. Then they get back in the ring and there's more good wrestling. And then, like, Chris Hamrick, it looks like he's about to win by hitting some move. It looks like it was supposed to be a superplex, but then he reversed. I don't know. It doesn't look too good, to be honest. Then Veronica Kane, you know, the other blonde big boob chick who wasn't about to get raped in the fucking match earlier. Ugh, fuck that match. Anyway, Chris Hamrick grabs her and her on the ring apron in the finish, but then I don't really know who it is. Like, the camera work is terrible and this quality is terrible, but they step on a landmine. What the hell? And then Chaos picks up the win on Hamrick. Like, what the fuck is going on in this show? Like, honestly, you had a really damn good match for a good chunk of this time with Chaos and Hamrick, but then you decide to fuck it up by having them brawl in the crowd for a little bit with the fucking fans and the terrible camera work, and then that weird finish. What the hell? For that, I can't really give this any grade higher than a C. I'm really sorry. I mean, this match could have been great. Could have been the best match of the night. But anyway, yeah. Next match. All right, it's main event time as XPW World Heavyweight Champion White Trash Johnny Webb, who honestly looks like the least convincing wrestler I'd ever seen, and that's excluding the trash bag man from earlier. And this guy, he seriously looks like Oliver Platt from Ready to Rumble. Honestly, why the fuck? This guy can't be good in the ring. And guess who his opponent is? Terry fucking Funk!
I am not even joking. See, there he is. Like, oh my god, this match better be something of worth. And it's not! Johnny Webb just waves around his kendo stick or something, like trying to be all, I guess he does karate or something? I don't know. As Terry Funk just randomly starts throwing chairs into the ring, and then all the fans start throwing their chairs into the ring, making a huge mess, and we get an ECW chant from the fans, which honestly, they're just reminding me what I'd rather be watching right now. And, this match, Johnny Webb and Terry Funk, they're just, all they're doing is running around punching each other and pinning each other with things. That's about it. I mean, they're running around through the crowd and we can't see shit. Then there's a part where Terry Funk just randomly crawls into a tent and pops out of it. What? Then he tosses Johnny Webb onto a pile of barbed wire, then grabs some random thing wrapped in barbed wire, spins around and falls on his butt. Oh man, poor Terry Funk. Then they fight into the pools of kiddie pool crap. Why? Oh my god, Terry Funk, why would you let them do this to you, man? I know you love this business, but that is just sad. You're the true hardcore legend. You're so much better than this. Then later on in the match in the ring, Terry Funk takes his branding iron, and a fan actually helps him light it up as he then spits a fireball into Johnny Webb's face. And while they're just flopping around, Johnny Webb gets a roll-up, and he wins. It's bad enough he had to do all this shit, Terry, but the fact that you also put this guy over? What the fuck? This match is awful. I don't know if it's worse than the rape spot match earlier, but it's pretty bad. Either way, this match can take two and shove it up its ass. Fuck this match. So, overall, my thoughts on this show, I'm gonna give it a C. C. Now, this show wasn't nearly as bad as, like, other XPW shows, which I may review in the future, but, yeah, there's just so much to hate about it, while there is a little bit to like about it. Like, the opening match was literally nothing as it got shafted for Vic Grimes and Gimpy Man. Then you had the Lucha Libre match, which was pretty good, not too bad. And then you had Supreme and the Trash Bag Man, like, fumbling around for a few minutes with that shitty suicide dive. Then you had, like, R-Truth and three other random dudes that nobody remembers or cares about. You had Chris Hamrick and Chaos putting on a decent match, but then gets ruined by silliness. And you had complete shit like that rape spot match. Then you had the and Terry Funk in possibly the worst match of his entire career. Ugh. And there were still some bright spots, like the Altar Boys versus like the Guy Fieri and Eminem tag team. That was a surprisingly really damn good match. And Psychosis versus La Parca was great and really didn't belong in this card at all. But anyway, Mother Machachos, that's the end of this review. And stay tuned and subscribe to my channel, because I've officially decided the identity for this channel will be to talk about the best, the worst, the bloody, and the just plain weird moments of professional wrestling. As next time, we're going to be starting a new series on this channel. It will be a 5-part series on Wrestling Society X. That's right. Now, shout out to channels like Wrestling with Regret and Marky D for pretty much inspiring me to do this kind of stuff on my channel. Yeah, just shout out to like a bunch of different wrestling channels, honestly. So anyway, Mother Machachos, that's the end of the video. Like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Children and bones, children and bones, the best looking dinner that I've ever seen. You better go get you some chicken and...
Chicken and lime? What is a chicken and world?
Beans, meat world, beans!
I don't feel good.
No, you're doing great.
No, I'm not!